It's one of the oldest churches in the world, the Church of the Nativity.
This is the place where Jesus Christ was born.
Professor Kastandi Shamali teaches history at Bethlehem University and is an expert on the Church of the Nativity.
The Church of Nativity was built over this place in 326 when Emperor Constantine decided to declare Christianity as the official religion of the Roman Empire. Since then, pilgrims from all around the world started coming to Bethlehem to visit this place.
Inside the church, the original columns from the 4th century still stand. Constantine's mother, Queen Helena, built the church. But why would she build it here?
We do know that the identification of the site of where Jesus was born already traditionally goes back to the middle of the 1st century AD at least.
In the 1st century, the Roman Emperor Hadrian destroyed the town of Bethlehem. After he destroyed the town, Hadrian built a temple and planted a grove of trees over the site where Christian pilgrims had come to honor the place where Jesus was born.
What was left of the house, which was only a cave, where the Virgin gave birth to the child. And people remembered this, and people already within 15 years were going back to that site to visit it.
In fact, this temple, instead of destroying the place, preserved the place.
Jerome wrote in 396 AD, "Even amongst those who are strangers to the faith, it is known that inside that grotto, he who is adored and glorified by the Christians was born." Through the centuries, the church itself went through a number of changes, but it's still one of the few churches in the Holy Land that was never completely destroyed. This is the main entrance into the Church of the Nativity. It's called the Door of Humility because you have to bend down in order to get inside the church. It was originally built by the Crusaders and then altered by the Ottomans in order to keep mounted horsemen out of the church. 1,400 years after Queen Helena built the church, Christian pilgrims still come from around the world. Many record their personal pilgrimage both inside and outside the church. The central place lays inside the grotto. Many believe it's the very cave where Jesus was born. A star marks the exact location. Many crowd down the narrow stairs to get inside the cave. Down below, pilgrims often touch the star and record the moment they got to see the birthplace of Jesus. For many, it's a profound emotional and spiritual experience.
What did it mean to be at the birthplace of Jesus?
Something I cannot describe. I mean, everything makes sense and no words. I mean, it's difficult. I'm really surprised.
Now when I open my Bible, as I do each morning when I'm here and I'm reading, well, now I can picture the places.
It's just unbelievable. It's a live stream. Never expected to be here, but it's just awesome.
Father Peter Vasco leads pilgrims to Bethlehem. He says it's especially meaningful during the Christmas season.
I think it's an absolute wonderful occasion for pilgrims to come, especially so close to Christmas, to be here to pray at the spot where Jesus was born and to bring that prayer back in their own lives.
But another event recorded in the Bible took place after Jesus was born. Professor Shamali gave us a rare look underneath the Church of the Nativity. Yes.
This is the place where we have the tomb of the innocent children. Herod killed around 6,000 children from the whole area in order to kill Jesus Christ because he don't want to have a new king that will replace him.
We followed Professor Shamali down to some of the tombs below the church.
Here are the tombs of the innocent children. These are the bones of some of the children that we believe were killed by Herod.
But another significant event took place just outside Bethlehem. Pastor Steve Corey, a local pastor, showed us caves many believe were used by the shepherds on that holy night. Luke 2, 8 through 11 says, "And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, 'Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord.
According to history, shepherds would use these caves to store the sheep during the winter, to store their food in the caves, and also places to live with them. You know, the shepherds were very close to their sheep.
Those shepherds became the first witnesses to the fulfillment of a prophecy given 700 years before, when Isaiah proclaimed, "Therefore the Lord himself will give you a sign. The virgin will be with child and will give birth to a son and will call him Emmanuel." Today, that Christmas message is still the same for pilgrims, professors, and pastors.
The reminder that God himself came to earth to die on the cross and to be born in a manger. And this is the essence of it, is that people's lives are changed. People's lives will be changed if they hear about Jesus Christ.
Chris Mitchell, CBN News, Bethlehem.